In this video, I'm going to explain how paint action sequences are used to turn video into automatic animation and rotoscoping in Studio Artist. Then I will show you how to output an animation or movie, and finally how to do some basic editing. I'll also show you how to save a paint action sequence preset to your favorites. So first, let's bring up the paint action sequence mode, and then choose the collection for movies. I'll just pick this first preset to get started. Before you can process, you will need to load a source movie, which appears in the source area here. You can do that with File, New Source and Canvas, and then choose a source movie. You can find the source movie that we are using for this tutorial in your Studio Artist folder, under a few images and source movies. I'm fine with this canvas size, which is standard HD. So I'll click OK. If you want a higher resolution such as 4K, you need to change the canvas size before you output your movie. But you can work at lower canvas resolutions while you are designing. We actually recommend that you do that since the presets will run faster. Then when you are finished designing, you can resize the canvas to the higher resolution for your final movie output. So now, I'll run this preset by pressing Action so you can see the effect. Now I will process the source movie with the paint action sequence preset by choosing action, process with paint action sequence, and then choose source to movie. Then you need to name and save your movie. Studio Artist will then start processing your movie, frame by frame, using the paint action sequence. When it is through processing, it will appear in the movie player. Here is the result of this particular preset. Next, I'm going to show you how to edit this paint action sequence. First, I'm going to redock the paint action sequence window and move the timeline over so we can see this better. Next, I am going to playback the steps one by one by clicking on the red square next to the step. Each step is rendering in the canvas so I can see it. I like everything in this paint action sequence except for these last three steps. So I am going to undo them. With Ctrl-Z on Windows and Command-Z on Mac, be sure that record is unchecked if you don't want to delete these steps. I just want to mute them so they won't play back. So I'll check mute for these three steps, and now play this last step. Next, I am going to add a vectorizer preset to this paint action sequence. But first I want to point out, when I played back the steps, this also changed the mode. It's now in the image operation mode because that last step was from an image operation mode preset. The mode will change to whatever mode was used to create the step that you clicked on. This will also bring up the editor for each step, which is convenient if you need to make a few tweaks. This is discussed further in other videos. For now, I am going to change to the vectorizer and then choose this preset to add. But first, I need to check record in the paint action sequence window. Then I will press the action button. As you can see, this preset has now been recorded as a step, and it's added this kind of shadowing effect. I'm happy with this look, and I'm ready to rerun this edited paint action sequence. So I'm going to toggle back to the paint action sequence mode. Before I process this paint action sequence out to a movie, I'm going to quickly save it to my favorites folder by holding down Ctrl for the Mac and right-clicking for Windows. And then mousing down in the paint action sequence window and choosing export paint action sequence preset. You can also save by choosing file, export, export paint action sequence preset. Just like before, I will process this movie by choosing action, process with paint action sequence, and then source to movie. After I name and save my output, my movie will begin rendering. After it's finished, it will appear in the video player, just like the last video we output. Here's the result of this edited paint action sequence. The next getting started with animation and movies video will show you how to minimize flicker.